This year, Eurovision is in sunny Lisbon, which I can already confirm is about 1,000 times better than Melbourne and 10,000 times better than Adelaide. I've been given 24 hours to explore the city. Obrigada! Let's get lost in Lisbon. Okay, I'm actually lost. Mi scusi, signor.
That's Italian.
Good.
If you do happen to get lost in Lisbon, the key landmarks aren't hard to spot. There's the Lisbon Cathedral, the Church of San Antonio, the Church of San Domingo, and about 10,000 other churches. But we want to get off the blessed beaten track.
Garden of Limp Dicks. That's literally what it translates to. Apparently, it got its name because it's a square that's usually filled with pervy old men.
The best way to get around Lisbon is via the hottest transport SBS money can buy.
Are you serious? Hola. Oh. Lisbon's adorable, but tuk-tuks on cobbled streets?
After several minutes of an involuntary pap smear, it was time for lunch.
Do you have a porto here?
A what?
A porto. It's like traditional Portuguese chicken. Obrigada.
If you can even believe it, there's no oportos in Portugal. And their national dish is not even chicken.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So what is this exactly?
It's the grilled codfish. We have more or less 300 ways to make some codfish. And this is the...
This is way number 60.
More or less.
The country's national drink is gin ginger.
Salud.
Salud.
Which contains a bunch of berries, caramel, and more importantly, alcohol. There are so many quaint places to visit in Lisbon. And so many, how you say, creepy places.
Welcome to the Dolls Hospital.
Whoa.
This is one of Lisbon's weirdest tourist attractions. It's room after room of creepy-ass dolls who I am fairly certain come alive at night and plot murder.
Oh my God.
Hello.
But if any place was going to have what I was looking for, it was this one.
Nice to meet you. Do you have any voodoo dolls?
No.
No, you don't have any voodoo dolls?
No.
No voodoo dolls that look like Israel's entrant to Eurovision?
No.
My ingenious plan to eliminate Australia's Eurovision competitors just wasn't going to happen.
It's probably best that you don't have voodoo dolls.
But I still walked out with a doll.
It's a typical doll of Portugal. Mm-hmm. It's the singing of Fran.
Oh, right, like a traditional Portuguese singer.
Yes.
Then you
Fado. A uniquely Portuguese way of singing. There are fado clubs all over Lisbon, some where anyone can get up and sing.
If I wanted to sing like Whitney Houston,
If you know some fado, yes, you can do it.
Let's go.
But that doesn't mean everyone should get up and sing. Some of us are just better suited to large jugs of Portuguese wine.
Buenas noches.
That's Spanish.